let's play. Ugh. Blood Moon, Questing Druids, Great, Three Bone. Okay, it's actually looking really good now. Little seven cards, so that's great. Ooh, top fuckers, library, maybe this one. Cast exile card this turn at the beginning of the next combat phase this turn. That's pretty cool. Cool. So, fight, you cast it. Extraordinary Journey's good. Let's see the rest of this. That's great. That's really good. What is good in the blues with that rare? Black. Oh shit. Three voracious vermins. That's a good deal. What's red have? Mainly that rare. Use splash. Green's pretty dope. Oh, I don't like that card. Okay, I'm a fan of this green black deck. Maybe it's green black white. Oh, that's cool. We always play everything, jeez. Loading the green cards in. I think I'm a big fan of this card. Sign of Leaping Ambush. Let's see. I can't not play it. Curious. Sorry for boring you. I feel like I don't externalize my dialogue very often. This card seems really good, like I can't not play it. It's good with rats too. Let's wonder what the mix is of green, white, and black. Let's just put the best cards in and figure it out. This actually might be good in Tangible Virtue. I guess for Vigilance doesn't matter for rats. I want to put that team drop we have. Ugh, not even that good. That's three less though. Count 16 creatures. I bet you don't kiss her with your eyes closed. I bet you're still walking on a tightrope. Maybe I play this, create a wicked roll. That might be relevant. Oh yeah, I'm definitely playing this rare. Jesus. I feel like I need to play this stupid card. Oh, Sean, I don't know. I can't even see the chat on Twitter. Okay, maybe it's not good enough. Spoilers maybe gets cut. Everything else seems really good though. Even Dream Spoiler seems good. No other great white cards. Oh, do I play Prism? Got two Violet Crystal Wilds, two. Be right back. I need water to talk through this bullshit. This should be a slam dunk deck. I mean, you don't need this shitter. That's where maybe I play Scarecrow or a Prism. It's a 2-1 body matter that much. Hey, Sean. Maybe you don't. Oh, you do have voice privileges.
I joined muted. I'm hanging out in bed.
Oh, nice.
I think your writ might be better than your...
Ooh, I forgot. No, because I forgot about this fucker. Thanks. Yeah, I totally spotted that first.
Also, the elemental is really strong.
Which elemental?
The six mana one? The red one.
I did not. Oh yeah, this. Yeah, you're talking about this guy.
Yeah.
I mean, does that go out instead of... I mean, white and black are kind of meh. Just the vermin drew me in.
Yeah.
Did Ryan really get kicked out of the party?
What?
What? Damn it. I just heard a bunch of bullshit in text, and I couldn't really discern what was real, fact, or fiction. How'd your party go?
It was fine. It was pretty mellow.
Nice.
It was, you know.
Okay, I think you are right. This red did a little bit better. Do you like Flick a Coin?
Yeah, Flick a Coin is one of the top performing red cons.
Really? That's cool.
Yeah.
Catapult, treasure.
I think I'd probably play Curse of the Werefox too, since you ended up cutting a lot of the black removal.
I mean, I could still play, but like, I guess I only have the fairy. That's like the best one. It's even not even that good unless you have fairies in play.
Yeah. Also, the Shatter the Oath card is not even very good. Pretty mediocre.
Shatter the Oath.
The 5-mana black removal spell.
Yeah.
Oh, you want to get Song of Whatever in there too, right?
Song of Whatever.
The X red.
Oh, of course. That's the whole reason to play that. What do I want to splash, if anything?
What does your blue look like?
I mean, hatching plan, I don't really have much bargain in this deck. But I mean, that card's pretty nuts. These are good game enders for all my mana ramp.
Yeah. You could, just play a couple more white cards if you wanted to splash, like the 3 Blind Mice and the Acolyte.
Oh, yeah.
And maybe the Glass Casket.
No, I like that. Because that's an easy splash. All those cards are pretty strong.
Something to think about is that you have a bunch of the Scarecrow, right? And do you have a second Prophetic Prism?
Oh yeah, I totally do.
So
have you liked Scarecrow?
I think it's fine. Something to think about is that you could play the Black White Legend. If you're playing enough of those, 5-color fixers.
Yeah, you wouldn't, I guess,
it's a little sketchier.
Yeah, it'd be nice if I had one of those green rampers that filtered, too.
Mm-hmm.
Graceful Takedown. I mean, I could play, it'd be just for this guy, really.
Yeah, you know, it's...
Right now, I feel like I could probably cut even Prophetic Prism and be happy.
Do you like the Leaping Ambush card a lot?
It just seems like one of the best combat tricks. I mean, maybe not as good as Hexproof and +1/+1. I don't know. I just feel like it. There's not much removal in this deck, and it seems like it might be kind of fun and tricky.
Yeah.
I don't really need...
What's our creature count right now?
Ugh, 12 creatures. Yikes, maybe it is.
Maybe one,
I mean, that's a creature, too.
Yeah. We are kind of wanting to have a little bit of access to black anyways with the... Gingerbread Hunter.
Oh, Dodoy. Yeah, we're playing this then. I mean, Crystalline Grotto.
I don't know if we even need a swamp, though.
You don't think so? I feel like it would. It would make me feel better. I mean, is this card, that card, it can't be something worth playing. I gotta take out one of these cards. I've got Redcap Thief, too.
Yeah. Also, Kincoin creates a treasure.
Oh, yeah. Whatever, then. Oh, yeah, you're totally right. Six, seven, eight, five. That's probably pretty good mana. Still doesn't really help. Oh, oh, there we go. Creatures 15. I don't think I really need this guy. Have you played with this guy?
Yeah, I think that Daredevil's really good.
Yeah. Damn it.
Something to remember with three blind mice is that, like, you can make copies of other tokens, so like rolls and stuff, or if you can get like a bigger creature token or something.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Hmm.
You could maybe play one of the haste 4/4s if you wanted to.
One of these guys, these five drops.
If you wanted to like up your creature count or something.
Maybe I'll just play another one. I got this 1/3 or a 4/2. Now I want to see how this ambush card does.
Okay. If you're thinking about trimming, I don't know. I am not the biggest fan of the Tooth Genealogist card.
Tooth Genealogist. Jesus. How do you know all these names?
2/3 for 3. Green.
Oh. I thought I went okay with this card. That's what I was like.
That makes sense.
But yeah, it is kind of medium. A 2/3 that would like what boost up like my defender guy.
Because like you're not even wanting to put the questing druid on 2. You don't really want to like have to suit up your Bramble Familiar necessarily.
Yeah, you're right.
It just like I think you want to play that card in more of like the Balgust, the like 2/2 for 2 with celebration. Like that kind of deck, you know?
Is this guy reasonable? I just need time with this deck, really.
Yeah. I don't think it's the worst thing. Mm-hmm. You want to just, like, no fours, too.
Yeah. Let's try it out. I haven't really played with it much.
I kind of like Candy Trail, also. I don't know how you feel about that card.
Oh, I haven't really tried playing with it yet. I liked it more in my food decks, like, but like I don't have much use out of it besides that. I mean, it's good value. Food Clue. It's scrying.
Yeah. I mean, it's just like a reasonable card, and also just having another thing you can do on one allows you to like fix your mana, kind of, or just filter your draws. It just smooths a lot of stuff out.
Let's try it out. Yeah, I'm not really sure how the streaming works. If like people can comment? I don't know. Work. Yeah, it feels like a mulligan.
Yeah, I think I'm mulligan too. I guess we keep.
Yeah, I guess Feral Encounter doesn't really need to get played. I don't know.
Yeah, I would check Feral Encounter. Yeah.
Yikes.
It's like B just like playing questing. Oh. Okay. I think we might just be playing questing through it on two.
Actually, with Monstrous Rage is a pretty good combat trick.
Yeah. So Monstrous Rage makes it a 5/3 for a turn, but a 3/3, right? Remember, so we can just we could also play the mountain next turn and have double combat trick to pump it twice.
Oh shit, I forgot about those spells. I'm just gonna stack up.
Yeah.
Do you think that's probably better than... I don't know.
So, I don't know. I think that here I'd probably go mountain, blow up as catapult.
Blow up as catapult?
And then probably...
Oh, like let him block?
I guess you could just go.
Oh, I see. This is an artifact. Oh, yeah, yeah. I kind of like that.
And then if he blocks, you could daredevil and kill this guy. That makes sense to me. We could also monstrous rage there, but.
Oh, he's not targetable.
Yeah. I don't think that that matters.
No attacks.
I'm kind of worried about getting cut into here.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Shit creatures. Wow.
Oh, this is very good for us.
Can I just cast both so I can cast this next turn?
So if we play our forest, we can cast both next turn too, right? Is there a reason? So I think that we're blocking.
I see. Yeah,
is there
better.
A reason that we want the monstrous roll on the other guy, right? Because then it can block and our daredevil can block and kill both either of its guys, right?
Yeah.
So I think that we just +2/+1 here and then go forest. Just the daredevil pumps. Oh.
I have to win this combat, right? Sorry.
So I was thinking that we would want the monstrous rage on the daredevil to make it a 5/3.
Oh, you're... I get a counter and I get +2/+1. Oh, you're right. I didn't really need to. Okay, cast that one.
So I... Yeah.
No, oh, you're right. Well, it'll be fine either way.
Yeah, we're huge.
I think I just played this guy.
Can we...
You can't really block my guy. Oh, I guess he can double block. But that actually would blow him out. Let's see if he does it.
Okay. Yeah, because we have 5 damage.
We have 4-2. Go to swamp.
Here.
Or is that we'll go to white?
Yeah, I would. Do you want to play back white?
Oh man. You're still right on that turn. I feel so dumb. I don't know why I didn't think it was plus 1 toughness.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. It's pretty sweet.
I'm kind of like into him killing our druid a little bit, or
going after the druid.
Just something. Because then we can acolyte it back and then use play it to draw cards effectively.
Mm-hmm.
I think we also just trade off for Daredevil here. So like our put our 4-2 in front of the 3-4 something, right?
If he wants to attack, I would definitely make that trade.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Cool. And yeah, this is sick. And then we can accolade our guy on top of our library. Draw it. Oh.
Next one might be better.
Yeah, I think.
Because we can act like act when we can actually cast it, maybe, too.
So, what do you think about just playing Red Cap Thief here?
Getting the.
And then getting in for 5.
I like that.
And then we can blow up his 0-4.
Yeah, I might actually do that now, so he doesn't get more pings out of me.
Yeah, I think it does. You might just jump or something.
That's true. Let's see. Oh, no, I mean, I'm not now, but like, yeah.
This turn.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I guess he really wants that roll. Young hero roll.
Yeah.
So maybe that'd be actually a thing to follow up.
I guess. Because then he doesn't start attacking again.
It might not be worth you, though. I'd rather like let him in. I don't know. I have a 6-7 in a second.
Yeah, I mean, I think we should have blown up something. That's a sorcery, by the way.
Oh, yeah. No, you're right. I was just. It seemed like a rare card, basically. Well.
Yeah.
All right. Well, it doesn't matter. Do I do it now? No, this is already done now. It's toughness.
So we could. I think I blow up his 0-4.
with a Vanguard.
Mm-hmm.
Firebolt is 3-3. And then put my Daredevil back on top of my deck.
Okay.
And then, because then we, he only has his 2-4 left over, right? And then we get in for like 8 here, put him to 6.
So wait, we Wild Acolyte this turn? Return Daredevil back?
I guess we don't need to Wild Acolyte this turn. But I would Firebolt his 3-3. And just like make sure you're not gonna run out of time.
This is pretty cool.
I would definitely keep.
Yeah. I kind of want to do red for Utopia Thrall.
Yeah. I think so. Especially with Scarecrow in our hand.
Mm.
It's just like... We're not going to be able to function if we don't have access to red. So.
Turn 2 red caps for speed. Aww. I don't think we keep it, right? Mm. No, we don't really have any enchantments. I mean...
It's just good by itself, too.
Yeah. I'm still, like, I'm off by some mana.
I think maybe we just need lands.
Yeah.
I'm just play deep here.
It's kind of a weird turn. Just discard my hand, so, draw 2 cards.
We could attack. We could just pass and then hold up, flick a coin if he tries to like get in.
We might so pump just, to like, trade.
Sorry.
Flick a coin in case he tries to get in with this guy.
Yeah, or we could just attack, see if he does anything. If he just takes it, then we just get him for 2 and play the 4-2. If he blocks, then we can, like, use the Daredevil pump spell.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we just play 4-2.
I just want to swing for 2 and get flick a coin value. Let's see. That's green, red.
Yeah. I mean, he could just trade by pumping his guy once, but I think that's fine for us.
That's true. Then maybe we swing with both. Yeah, I think so.
He could block the 2-3 on our 2-3 and try to Dream Spoiler, which is it?
Oh, does Dream Spoiler count itself when it comes into play?
No.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no, not Dream Spoiler. The, like, kill something that's been dealt damage this turn.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, yeah. Acolyte too. likely a good one.
yeah.
Oh well.
Second main. I think we can cast the black white card, right?
Yeah, we can. Return that.
They could get a spell stuttered, but I think that's fine. Because we can acolyte it back.
We just gotta use a treasure. That's fine.
I might have let us astray this game.
I guess we could put a scarecrow. I don't know. Something will get a spell centered either way. Chill. Okay. Stop abilities. Weird. Oh my
If we draw land, we can play Glutton.
There we go.
We can sack the guy, probably.
Yeah, we don't necessarily need it now. We can do all this stuff.
I think we attack with the 2/3 first.
To possibly
and then try one. And get him to use the mana to trade with his own 2/3, and then that way he can't draw a card with a bitter chill.
Oh yeah, okay. I think he's gonna take it though. He's 19. And then he can just pump a bunch. Trigger. For elementals, I can cast this guy. He can tap all my guys and I think probably kill me next turn.
Is there. Should we use the draw two here? Like discard hand draw two? Trying to hit something?
I just don't want theirs to hit.
We could hit a fight spell.
Yeah. I'm gonna tap five. I'm gonna take. Ugh.
Our hearth elemental also costs two less at that point.
I probably should play the Evolving Wilds, but yeah, you know. Is pretty amazing.
Yeah, it's real strong.
Have Have you been liking this guy? Really brutal right now. Ooh, this game's over. I'm gonna blow myself up.
Wait.
The
candy trail games play.
And Drowsy. Do you have fun in this
the fight spell?
No. Yeah, I almost want to keep his hand. I think I'm gonna candy shell my way out of this. Yes. Evolving Wilds gets my white. I want this Daredevil. So nice to have a three drop. Okay. I feel like I probably should just play Evolving Wilds and then. No. It's not really going for it. Cool. I know, it makes me have to wait a couple turns to freaking cast Glass Casket.
I guess we have to play a 4-2 here.
I think that's the best play. Yeah, I feel like that might be the thing to do.
The food represents two games, right?
Yeah.
We kind of needed to just like give up on the Daredevil and
let's see what was on the deck had. What was on top after that? Forest. Yeah, maybe one card deeper. Oh, wow.
I guess that's.
I don't know. I think I gotta play this 4-5 and then I can have a better turn next turn.
Yeah, I think we're kinda. Wait. Yeah. I think we're just playing press and I'm playing 4-5.
But I need to remove it next turn if we stay around. I'm gonna get a swamp for this guy. I think he might be able to. for that.
Yeah, I think we glass casket as fairy.
Scarecrow?
I think we might just go Wild's Pass. Then
it's not instant though.
Hold up the takedown.
It's not instant. I wish it was.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I guess I'm just gonna keep holding Scarecrow until the point where we like.
What? Where's my swamp?
We didn't play a swamp.
Oh, okay, it doesn't matter, I guess.
I was thinking about holding Scarecrow until the point where we could Scarecrow plus Dude.
Make sure we have mana.
Make sure that we play around Flick a Coin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. He's playing blue back red. You can have Rat out and Flick a Coin.
Yeah.
Or Creeper.
Is there anything that we can get back? We can get back the +2/+1 card, right? The Daredevil from our graveyard.
Yeah, I mean that would help blocks, but I mean we could just trade for the big guy. Well, I could actually wait. I can bring it back, cast it, and then cast Graceful Takedown. This guy costs 4 mana.
Why don't we use the black white card to bring it back?
Oh yeah, Dedoy.
And then we can like chunk his screen puff with the Scarecrow guy, and then do your +2/+1 plus graceful takedown.
Yeah, that sounds better. Okay. Did he create a food with this? Deals combat damage to player. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Huh. Okay. Actually, this kind of works too.
That doesn't work as a. I mean,
it'll do extra damage. I can count him and like pump him or something, but
yeah. I kind of want to get our Vanguard killed so we can return it with Acolyte to blow up the Stab Wound.
Oh, he's saying it's my turn? Oh, what a prick. He's trying to drain me.
Yeah. So we could just attack with the elemental.
That's true.
And
I could pump it beforehand. I could kill it afterwards. Frantic Bolt. I have 7 mana. No, I only have 6.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is like, ugh. Yeah, he's definitely not going to attack.
Do you think he just played a 6-7 here?
Maybe. He's at 20.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think maybe there's definitely some sort of big turn set up. Try to get him. Sealed deck was a lot worse than I thought. Okay, so let's see. I'm definitely gonna do.
Okay, we can actually use the Leaping Ambush to untap our guy. And block the Scream Puff.
And then we could Frantic Bolt it. I like that.
I'm saying that, like, we can. When he. If we attack with the Elemental.
Yeah, yeah,
he's going to attack us. Yeah. And then we untap our guy and block.
Yeah, we can print it bold.
But we could also just like daredevil it, right? I'm surprised he didn't attack with the 3-2.
And I was actually happy to make that trade. Thanks to blockers.
If we block here, do we daredevil our guy? I think we do.
Oh. Yeah, it probably doesn't matter instead of casting the Phantom Bolt.
Oh, okay.
He's giving his guy minus power. Wait, we can daredevil his guy, and then Frantic Bolt it.
Yeah, that's true, that's true.
Funny. Okay.
I mean, I think that you do that.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, but my guy, now I can still Frantic Bolt.
Yeah, because we'll have another creature.
You can cast that turn.
Oh, wait. Yeah, we can still Frantic Bolt the Scream Puff and then give play the 4-2 and then take down the 3-4.
What's the 4-2? Oh, it's my hand. Oh, duh. Okay, you're right.
Yeah. We're still in. So I think that we want to block with our 2-2 so we can rebuy it with the acolyte. I guess we want access to black mana though.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. We need other good cards.
Okay. Double block?
I will definitely double block. I'll block there too.
What's just, in our graveyard?
It fights though. It's so rough. I mean, we could return this.
Oh, we can get the hearth.
Oh, the hearth elemental? Yeah. Let's see. We have 6, 7. I thought we could. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, no, we can't.
So we could do.
Yeah, I think you're right. Hearth and spells cheap.
So yeah, so we go Plains, Revive Hearth Elemental, play our Acolyte, and then play Curse of the Werefox with the Acolyte, and I guess we don't curse here, we just try and just hope cast. It works, and we trade.
Yeah.
Wait.
Oh, the trade.
Oh, you're just playing the 4-5. Okay. Yeah, sure. You're right.
Oh, wait. No, because it's another spell. I can discard it, right?
No. We don't have double red.
Oh, shit. I should have my mana better. I'll let it decide. There's definitely another way around. Okay, whatever. Draw another creature to get out of this flying creature. Yeah. Well, it's been fun kind of clawing onto the game. Sad showing.
You want to look in her build again?
Yeah.
Maybe we just cut the black card, just like a little bit too much on the man.
It feels like it shouldn't be though, you know? Mm-hmm. I mean, that would have been, that game would have been a lot easier if we had one swamp in the deck.
Yeah. I could see cutting in planes for a swamp.
It's three by mice. Mm-hmm. That dude. Yeah, I'm down for that. We'll try it out. Makes me want to just cut down to 40 cards.
Mm-hmm.
Except I feel like
the like rest of the field again.
What?
The rest of the pool.
I mean, there's other good 4-drop. I guess that Rainier doesn't do anything. This 5-drop's a pretty good flyer, though.
Yeah. I mean, both of our games, we get kind of beat down by flyers, right?
Yeah.
Maybe we just need something like that.
And just take this out. We're going to take, like, Candy Trail out or something.
Yeah, we can try that out. I mean, we also just haven't really drawn a lot of our...
good cards.
More powerful cards.
Draw all the shit cards. I love this 4-2 and aggressive decks. I'm just... there's lots of like plays, I guess, that have opportunities to do with it, which is nice. Oh wow, nice. I think my mana ramp guy.
Seems like a good one.
Yeah, seems great. So if he doesn't have a removal spell, right?
Yeah. I mean, as long as he doesn't play a swamp here.
Oh. Oh my god.
Oh, I think we play Red Cap Thief actually here. Because that would be wrong, we can just go the 5-draw and just start cracking his skull. What do you think about playing Glass Casket plus Bramble Familiar here?
Oh, I see. Yeah, it seems fine.
You can just...
yeah, it's gonna be like... no, I think let's just do it. Oh, no, because it's like, oh man, we just missed our land drop too.
Yeah.
I would definitely trade with this guy.
The 2-3?
Yeah. Definitely sugar.
I think maybe we should have just played 3 blind mice there instead of the familiar.
Yeah, we're running scared. We should have been confident with our turn 2 blind mice.
I mean, if we get okay, that was really good that we saved with Glass Casket.
That's really good.
I think we trade.
Yeah.
It's here we're just going 3 blind mice plus Glass Casket.
We can't do that. Oh no, you can.
Yeah, we can.
I'll have you have that. Nice.
And then green here with your falling lines?
Do we want our black just in case?
Did we cut the black 2/2? I guess we, yeah, we probably take the black. I'm trying to think about like double green spells, but we do have
access we have this to guy.
Second green with the familiar.
Oh, nice. Don't have that right out. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Oh. Yeah, sorry. I just got a little too caught up about my mice.
I guess we're just playing Scarecrow Guide plus Pocketing Wilds.
Yeah, yikes.
To get the swamp area.
Well, at least I'll get this guy on the right turn to attack. Tap the crow. Yes. This guy?
I think you suit up your Scarecrow Guide and just pass. And then that way.
I think you suit up Scarecrow and you're gonna attack with it too. It's kind of no profitable. I'm gonna attack for a lot next turn.
Okay. Because you're thinking that he won't trade the Sentry for it?
Yeah, I don't think he will. I think he likes the sentry. But we'll see. If he double blocks, I'll kill sentry, I guess. Nice. Oh, that's be a good combat phase. Ooh, he had to kill the enchantment. Well, this is going to be great. We got to do this, right?
Yeah, barrel encounter here, yeah.
And then have... Yeah.
It's not a fight, it's just deal damage.
Oh, it's even better. Oh,
that was a good one. We just play that now.
This card?
Yeah, your acolyte. Oh!
I can't cast it, right?
Interesting. So we can...
Oh, I see.
We can put the... So we can put the three blind mice on top of our library, and then we can questing druid during his turn. Yeah. Okay, so we can just go to attacks.
Our creature you control.
You just attack everybody.
Yeah.
Hit him for 10.
In until your next end step. Oh, perfect. Okay, that makes sense. It's an instant.
Yeah.
Those cards are. Oh shit.
Yeah.
Do I just Frantic Bolt? Sure. Questing Druid Frantic Bolt?
I don't think so.
Or you just. If I Frantic Bolt, I put him down to one life and just attack all my guys. Or is it three
you
life?
Think that's better, have, or do you think it's.
2/2.
You could just like three blind mice, like Questing Druid, three blind mice, attack him with your 4/4.
Sure, I'll go for that. That's fine. I have a 3/3, so if I kill
6 mana?
Oh, that's why I can't use Frantic Bolt, because I didn't do that turn.
Do we Witchstalker and then draw some cards with Hearth Elemental?
That seems like a pretty good idea. Oh, nice. Thanks, buddy.
I mean, I kind of was thinking it would be just like wait 2 turns and then kill him with the 3 blind mice goes off.
Of course, you did. Just like playing with your food. His poor soul. He's want to sit there and just. It's so nice. I played High Tide on Friday. And my first round opponent was like going off, and she's like, you can just win. I don't want to see any more of this. I was like, oh, thanks. I haven't played this deck before, so.
I'm spamming them.
Oh, this is pretty nice. I know it's kind of, it sucks that this will cost 4 mana, but I'm fine with this.
I think we're good, yeah. So do you just get a forest here?
Yeah. I think so.
There is like maybe it's just bad. Like getting the swamp there. Okay, that was weird.
Grotto. What? Oh, probably should play Grotto. Yeah, you're right.
I think you sprawl for green.
Really? Yeah, we're gonna be up on mana.
I'm thinking that we sprawl for green because we're gonna play Red Cap Thief on next turn, right? Or we have access to play because the Utopia Sprawl puts us ahead, one ahead on mana. So the Gingerbread. I'm just trying to make it so we can cast our Glutton, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna cast it anyways. Just, I don't want to draw a card.
Yeah. I think we -2/-2 is due on our turn, for sure.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty sweet. Have you played with that enchantment?
I haven't done it.
Do I want this? No, I don't want this.
Okay.
I have no white source.
Yeah, we have the grotto working. Oh shit. Now we're just playing a 5/5 next turn and getting a food.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna sack that food to a 6/6.
I mean, if we want to, we could just play like Red Cap Thief plus Monstrous Rage. And then we can sack the Monstrous Rage token. The Monster token. So we like preserve our life total more.
You think it's not better just to cast the Brute?
I think we play the 5/5 here.
Yeah.
Get a Hunter. Yeah.
Rough. What did he even do? He's cast that. Oh yeah, okay, whatever.
I think we red capped Thief here.
Really?
Yeah.
We could red cap Thief and cast. No, we can't. It's 4 mana. We definitely attack, right?
I don't think so.
Really? Ooh. I'll go this route. I like having Blue Coin up. Oh shit! Oh, there's pressure. Okay. Oh, I can't use both. That's what I was hoping for.
Good coin makes a treasure.
Okay, I can do all the things.
Yeah.
Okay.
Three. I mean, you got it.
Yeah, it's a little sacrifice.
So we need to kill him fast now, I guess.
We can do it. I think I'm gonna trade with the coin here.
I think so, yeah.
Glutton in this guy.
Yeah. Sacking. Whoa, wait.
What?
Do we sack the Utopia Sprawl here?
Oh, you think the food's gonna matter?
I think it will matter more than the Utopia Sprawl.
Really? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, I don't want to.
Okay.
At least it's the thing of your upkeep, so. Nice. guess I wish. Do you think I play the other side of the spell first, or should I just do boom, boom, have this up?
I think that we want to get some cards. Like, what are the creatures in the graveyard right now? Yeah, pretty inconsequential.
So try to draw some cards.
Any cards in his graveyard? No creatures. So I think that we go 3 blind mice, attack him for 6, pass.
Yeah.
And then his end step, we exile the top 2, so we have 4 mana available.
That monstrous rage is gonna win the game.
Yeah, buddy.
Vermin. Sweet. What? You're up to one. Oh, fuck. Well,
I guess we're just doing it here.
Yeah.
Probably.
God, that sucks. We need a land to play. Well, there's nothing to kill.
I guess we could.
What?
I guess we.
I kind of want.
With our 6 problem.
I think we play Questing Druid and then attack. And then Monstrous Rage when he chump blocks. And just set up for the win when this comes into play.
I mean, it doesn't matter if he. Oh, you're saying, like.
Oh, this is already trample.
Okay. I get. Yeah.
Well, it's like we can cast Frantic Bolt and, what, kill one of his guys?
Yeah, like, we can kill the Voracious Vermin, right? So it makes it so he his creature isn't growing.
Yeah, let's do that.
I don't think we can get punished, so. So,
I think,
is it 14?
I make a bunch of guys and smash him, and then
yeah.
I save up monster. I can't save up Monster's Rage without making a couple less guys.
Yeah, I think you just make a bunch of guys with Song. So, do you just make a bunch of guys with Song and then pass? I guess you attack
for 6.
Rest. Probably the mouse. So you just like make 5 guys, right? And then just attack with your 1/1s. And then hold back. I guess you don't hold back your 6/6, right?
I think I just attack with everything.
He's maybe for 5, yeah. Just, yeah.
Fun life. Good game. Well, I drew the rare card. It's really good.
Yeah. Drew three rare cards.
Oh, nice. What was your draft like in top 8?
I had like a shitty green-black deck. It was... The signals were all over the place in the draft.
Mm-hmm.
It was... I think there was a bunch of people waffling, or like people who weren't very experienced with the format, and so... The, like, signals that were going around were... all over the place. I think we might want to play Scarecrow Reactor.
Oh, to have Frantic Bolt up.
I mean, we can play Frantic Bolt anyways, but,
Yeah.
If we play Scarecrow.
It actually attacks where the thing doesn't attack.
Yeah. Did you use Gron up here?
Probably. Throw away the Scarecrow.
That's kind of annoying.
Yeah. Pretty valuable.
Mm-hmm.
I don't need to scry. Ooh, extra value.
So.
Whatever. Worth the scry.
You might just. Ooh. Make two is.
That's pretty good here. I mean, otherwise sacrifice Scarecrow Guide and I can get in for a 3-3, and that doesn't seem that great. A 3-3.
Yeah. I think you just make two is guy, and then just like make a 5-5 next turn and
yeah. I don't know, guys can get good too.
Yeah. Because, like, I don't want to leave you, just, like, scry every turn, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you make a good with that guy? The,
Oh, dude, look at that. Oh, now he's a 4-4.
You can play just Hunter here, right?
Yeah. I think I double block here. Well, I don't know. I just hate that.
Yeah,
no.
I think we just take 4.
Yeah.
It sucks, but. Yeah, I think we're just doing that second thing.
We can get 3 damage bolts. We actually kill this guy now.
Yeah. That would be nice.
Season of Growth.
we go in on.
Just boom, boom. Well, I don't have six mana, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
But yeah, remember the end step questing druid?
You want to do that? Boom, boom.
No, I think you curse the glutton on the courier or courtier. And then you hold up to like exile the top two cards of your library on his end step.
Yeah, I'm down for that.
Stalker?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I am definitely gonna cast that spell.
Thing about that card is that like you can go 5 deep or 6 deep if you just mill the comp 4.
Mm-hmm. That's a bummer.
I mean, yeah, kind of sucks. Maybe he just doesn't have anything to do with it. So instead of questing druid here, I think I might hold it because I don't think we're casting the spells next turn because we want a firebolt, right?
But we can do that too. I really say, yeah, I see what you're saying.
This is like.
And maybe it's lands on top though, that's what I really want.
Yeah. I guess it's like just a decision.
Yeah, because it could just be red cap this next turn or something.
That's kind of what I was thinking.
Oh, that was the land. That's annoying that we have to use the treasure. Oh, that's a bummer.
I think we go planes.
Yeah.
Song for Max. Four.
Is it four? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, 5. Treasure. Attack with
him? No. I think I tried to incentivize him to hold back. You might be right though. You just lose a red cap thief and he takes 7. 14.
Does he have anything you can put back? Like, does he have any adventure cards?
Over this.
this thing? Yeah, no. There's his adventure card, though. I'm surprised he didn't want to wait a second.
Questing through the attack with everybody. Do you rage the rat here?
Oh, I think I do.
I think so. It makes him waste a lot of money. I think we should have attacked that last turn.
Yeah. We were down like a scarecrow guy down. We still have, you know, four guys.
Yeah.
Ooh. Attack. Whoa. Oh, I can cast this. Dope. We'll cast
on the wheel. Nice.
Yeah. You think I'd not attack now?
I don't think so. I guess. It's like he has a 5/5.
He could 7/7/7 me though before this goes off.
Yeah.
Cool. Did it get in 3 damage? We get 7 or 8 life? Yeah, you're probably right. No, they're just fucking shit rats. They don't matter. I'm just hoping maybe it kind of scares him or something.
Ooh. I guess you go real familiar.
It's ready for me to bounce right away.
Mm. We clear a land?
Nah. Yeah, that's pretty sweet. It's coming back online. Oh, he's copying that. Oh, that's pretty amazing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was only attacking with one guy? Oh my god, sure.
And we can just kill that dude because it doesn't stop activated ability.
Oh, that's really dope. That'll be good for blocking too next turn. You get no lifelink. We can do both too. We can cast this and have mana up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That leave the right mana up, yeah.
So you can activate it twice at instant speed. But if you don't do it now, then he'll have to think about using his legendary creature. Because if he gets rid of one of the cooped up, then he can start activating. He can activate that again.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
But I think you pass here. many cards do we have left in our library?
12 cards.
Interesting.
He's exiling that. Alright.
Wait, bounce.
Yeah. Perfect. Nice. What a sucker. Did you have another one? There. Should I just try to... It's like, I can't blow up this, I don't think. What do you think? I can get any... No, I mean, this is a creature enchantment or land, so like, a lot of the cards I'm going to whiff on. It's only two cards, though.
I think we just play a 2-2 and then draw two cards, right?
Yeah, you're probably right. I'm trying to wonder what I'm trying to draw here. There's no big creatures.
Yeah.
That's actually kind of relevant.
Oh, yeah, attack with everything. Because we can kill his 4/4 lifelinker here. Or we can kill his 6/6.
Oh, he's blocking the 4/4.
I think we kill the lifelinker.
I think so.
Yeah. Because, like, if he doesn't have lifelink, then he still might get chipped out, right?
Yeah. I think you're right.
So, what can we even get with that white creature?
I believe it's creature or enchantment cards. We can get back lights and start this dungeon again.
Yeah.
Otherwise, questing.
We can also get back questing.
I don't know if it's going to be good enough.
There's 9 cards left in our library.
Six, seven, so four. If I draw a land, I can cast this, and that. Go ahead and put one there.
Yeah, can we do...
We can do this guy, mice, and cast this guy.
Okay, yeah. I like that.
Sorry, that was making me choose what to copy. No attacks. I feel like you can kind of keep up with these tokens, though. I need to draw removal so I can end this shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty badass. Yena, red tooth regent.
many cards did they come with?
Seven. We've got seven. So we'll draw three.
Tom, if we deck with a 42 card deck,
preparing for the big turn. Cool. Oh, okay. I'm gonna take all of it.
Yeah.
You can still draw that big fireball card too and win.
In our graveyard.
You milled it?
I think we capped
it. Oh, duh. This game's been long. Jesus. There's not really any great permanents to return.
We could...
Dude.
So we probably don't...
We'll just cast it and draw a
card. By getting...
Another three.
Mice back.
Yeah.
So we could quest... We could get back questing druid.
But just more creature dorks. I think we have to just draw something.
I know, but like questing druid gets us further into our deck, right? I guess we just don't.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
But we don't have enough mana for that for fucking around with that, probably. So we probably just need to act light.
Let's see.
That's a really good one.
This kills a 7/7.
Yeah, it kills a 7/7 for sure. You can target multiple enchanted creatures. And then, yeah. Something else. Collect.
Doesn't work. Yeah. 9 damage. Yeah, like a...
And then nice. Attack with everybody?
Yeah. I gotta ambush and kill that vendor. Maybe. He's got 12 coming out.
I mean, we're killing the vendor anyways, right?
Yeah, do you think we save our guy?
I guess.
Otherwise, what we deal. We can do 11 damage instead.
Yeah. Having
creature might be more important than dealing one extra damage.
That's difficult. We gotta just cast Gingerbread to get food.
The cooped up and then play our guy, right?
Blow up this cooped up? Yeah, that's true. And then can we actually attack him this turn? He's only got four blockers. 1, 2, 3, 4. He's gonna take 4 damage.
Yeah. Let's fucking do it. Hello and good luck.
That felt really good.
Even after we spewed off like 4 or 5 damage.
Oh god.
Easy.
Sean, it feels so weird sorting magic cards just alphabetically.
Doesn't feel not.
I don't know, it just doesn't feel right. It feels so strange.
Like not in color?
Yeah, not in color. All the colors mixed up. Just like, wow. This hand seems kind of garbage.
Yeah, I think we ship this one.
Can get a lesser hand? Yeah, it's the same hand.
I think we keep. Maybe we pitch the takedown?
Maybe this card. Do you think so? Oh. It's the same kind of thing. I mean, maybe the casket.
Yeah.
I'm just hoping a creature.
Casket? We can cast it with Flick a Coin, right?
Oh, that's true. Treasure? Yeah, you think takedown's worse than this one?
Yeah, I think so.
Probably.
Just like maybe we can hit a red creature or something. Or, like, if we cast Feral Encounter on turn 6 or something,
we
have enough mana to cast something else, you know?
Come on, value.
I wonder if it was better to play another green there. Oh. Sick.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Oh, nice. Hurts so good. Okay, fine.
I think we just play 4-2. We're attacking for 2.
Yeah, I like that.
The 4-2 makes it so we can kill a lot of stuff with the Feral Encounter as well.
Yeah, I wonder what we get. I guess there's some good things we can draw off it. I'm really need another. With the treasure. Yeah. We'll probably get something.
We can kill like a grabby giant.
God, that's such good value. Oh, I can play this and then flip a coin.
I think that we want to draw cards with Questing Druid.
Oh, yeah. So, I could still play what, flip a coin and then do that?
Oh, wait, go to attacks.
Why?
I think.
Oh, so we can tap.
I guess he could have a pump spell, but I think that's kind of... So, yeah, because I think he taps this... And then we can flick his rainy and then get him. And then we can question Drew to draw some cards on his own stuff.
Mm-hmm. The mana really worked out.
Mm-hmm.
Utopia Sprawl and cast, just cast all this stuff. Boom, boom, boom.
Pretty much. I think we, Sprawl.
We do one. Well, we do Sprawl and Acolyte.
We'll do that. I think we Sprawl on white and then cast all of our stuff using a treasure.
Okay, I see. Yeah. Sense. This one has a good attack.
Sure.
Tap that shit.
I think we'd play the Bramble Familiar. That's just
a because no, I have to, yeah. Otherwise he goes away.
Yeah.
Well, it's nice to see this card get shit on. Really fucking them.
Yeah. I think.
Just do this into this.
I mean, we could.
I'll get a counter.
Yeah. You want to make sure.
What do I need to make sure of, though?
It doesn't use your green mana.
Oh my god.
To cast the 2/3 for the, like, white card.
Yeah.
Because you don't have anything to cast with green in your hand. So I think it would use the green mana from the Utopia Sprawl for the 2/2.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, is it hard? Actually, I haven't really tried to play with how I cast stuff or how to use mana.
I think I would just float mana, and then it works basically the same way as Magic Online, where you just click the dots that you want to use.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that seems reasonable, I guess. Or you can maybe kill something on turn.
Well, but it's been slow. I think if we were on the draw, this thing would have gone more.
I can see that, definitely. It's very lackluster. I guess I got some story.
I think we want to hold a fireball here.
You think so?
Or I guess we could play Daredevil.
Do you think blind mice is scary to run out this early? They just don't have the removal for it. A torch.
I think if he has a torch for the tower, then our three blind mice just does nothing this game.
Okay, I think we just play this.
Okay.
Yeah, because I mean, you could make a song afterwards, miss one of the triggers. But yeah.
Yeah, but we're good.
Oh, wow. I mean, I guess we'll just
pause. I think we just trade with the 3-2. Trimmed a mana off of our elemental too. It's pretty sick.
Oh, nice. It's getting better.
So, I think we just pass and hold up Firebolt on the Vermin.
Really?
Right. Yeah, because I think he's gonna wanna.
I like that.
I think if we're able to take out the Vermin, then it's going to be really good for us.
That's kind of annoying.
Yeah, but I think we're fine. I think we block the keep guard and then kill the Vermin.
You want to do it before damage, so he can't do +2/+2. That's a good one to draw.
Do you think you go dog plus mice here?
Yeah, I think that's the appropriate play. Ugh.
So, yeah. It auto tapped to leave up a light, so I don't think he has torch the tower. I don't know. We know he doesn't have Archon's Glory because
he can still have
he,
it.
Like,
I mean, it's not gonna be. It's not gonna be profitable on his block or attack.
It didn't stop when he.
Oh, that's interesting.
Could have had Cryo, I think.
Oh wow, he could return the +2/+2 one.
Yeah, he could have.
I guess it wouldn't have been that good. He just smashed in for a good number, though. Mm. Really? I mean, I'd probably just block, right? He's just hoping to grow Voracious Vermin. Oh, it's gonna get bigger anyways.
Yeah. I think we block, because, like, what are we doing?
Yeah.
And then, because like he's growing with something anyways. I think we cast. Do you cast song here for 4 tokens?
Or we just cast our this thing? Oh, we can't cast both. That's so annoying.
Yeah.
That's tough. Next turn, I guess we can cast both, huh? We'd prep for the final turn.
Yeah, I think we song for 4 tokens, and then
we could also. Oh no, yeah, you're right. And then what next? Turn these two, and then pop.
Yeah.
I think you're probably right. The other routes don't seem as good.
I mean, I don't think that we're dying next turn, and. Oh. We have to do 4, not 5. So I was thinking about, like, being able to make a food off of the next 3 blind mice thing.
Mm-hmm.
I think we don't block that if he gives us the opportunity.
Interesting. I mean, I'll block these all day. Food?
I think we just make a mouse here.
Yeah.
Because, like, he's just running out of things to do. I think we red cap plus bramble familiar. So, like.
Yeah, we're going to need a big fatty next turn.
And it's also, like, smaller than his vermin, anyway, right? Because I think we're just going to chump.
He's got 1, 2, 3 blockers. Four blockers.
So we go land Bronson.
Yeah.
That's pretty good, actually.
4.
I think we just swing out.
Yeah. Do we want to play this first so we can have him attack?
Oh.
Because otherwise we can get a good flick of the coin, maybe, depending on his blocks.
I think we're going to... I think we want to get a good flick. Yeah.
Then we can cast it main phase 2.
Yeah.
Okay. Doing red cap, it's blocking a 2/2. What do we want to kill most?
I think the 4/4. I guess the edge wall pack attacks as a 4/4 anyways, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we probably do that.
It's probably, yeah, that's about the same.
Yeah.
And men is slightly better. Okay.
Do we have We should have flicked his pack before damage.
Where's that?
Oh, flick his pack right now.
Yeah.
Because we could have drawn, like, a pump spell or something, like a monster spell.
Oh, I see what you're saying, yeah.
Second main.
There's oh, is he gonna resolve these things?
Just death, I guess. Mm-hmm.
moves.
So he has three blockers.
I think he most should attack with that rat. He's tapped all of his manas. No more tricks. I think he could actually block it. I really don't block it that well, though. Oh, my turn. And just Utopias for all this fatty?
Yeah. We get a Utopias Brawl on black. And then just...
I don't think we need to, though.
We want to play our land.
Oh, I kind of want to keep it. Well...
We could just cast our guy then and hold Utopias Brawl.
That's true. We can block this guy, this guy, this guy. Take five or three.
Because if he attacks a Screaming Puff, then we block with a 4-5 and a 1-1, maybe.
Yeah. Because the food is gonna. Yeah, that makes kind of sense. Ooh. Too scared to attack. Yeah, nothing to do. Oh my god. You'll pay life while you're living. Okay. Oh, that's interesting.
Basically, you're just gonna draw a lot of cards. Do you think it might have been reasonable for us to use all of our tokens on the Territorial Witch Stalker to kill the Ashiok?
Oh.
I think we maybe should have done that last turn.
Because now he's going to go to 5. I still have broken Scar Targler, is it?
Because, like, he kills our Witch Doctor plus a mouse and keeps the rest of his nightmares alive, probably.
Mm-hmm.
But his nightmares are just 1/1s at that point.
That's what you're saying. I already turned the blind mice again, but I don't know if we're gonna race that way. I don't know what the best plan is. What are creatures?
I mean, doesn't really have
it's to got make four thing. Blockers. One, two, three. Oh yeah, we could still kill Ashiok if we wanted to. Oh, it's got five
yeah,
now.
Yeah, but I think
no, you're right.
I think that doesn't really matter as much anymore, because I think if we go for the black white card into three blind mice, then we can just like kill him in three turns or whatever.
Do you think you do that now? Don't cast Questing Druid. Yeah, when you get down the
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we're a mana short. Just play Forest from the exile.
You're right though. We should have smashed in. Those people are awesome. Guys, but
yeah, we would have lost one mouse and a witch stalker.
In this hard zone. Yeah.
We didn't have to attack with that phone. We would have been able to attack back with the screen buff, but I think that was not as important. So we probably should have played our forest a previous turn or the Utopia Sprawl because we were mana short from having a 3/3 druid here.
Mm-hmm. I just like the cards that I felt like he was more so much more hesitant about being aggressive, but I needed him to be aggressive. I don't know. Yeah, you're right.
You can activate Cooped Up in instant speed, right?
Cooped Up?
Yeah, the pacifism.
Oh, that, yeah.
That.
So maybe I fight and kill the 4/4
or
the
3/1?
3/1? Yeah. Should I use the Witch Talker too?
You could, yeah.
I don't know, he probably would just have it.
So if you use the Witch Stalker, it becomes a 4/4 on attacks.
That's actually kind of nice, but yeah, because he can block any of these, doesn't really matter.
I mean, if you do that Hearth Elemental, then the Elemental trades flat with the Scream Puff, which is nice, so you can't attack with the Scream Puff profitably. Questing Druid.
Boom.
So we have a food available?
Yeah, might gain 3 life. Even that turn, like,
yeah.
Should we have attacked with all of our guys to kill Ashi? I don't know. No. What was that first turn?
Yeah. if we would have done that that turn, it would have been a better spot for sure.
Yeah, we'd be fine. I think we'll hold up. We wouldn't be dealing with two twos. Would he not exile a card? How does this work?
He exiled a land.
Oh, it has to be.
Oh, no, you need to go to combat.
Oh.
Okay. I mean, he's going tall, but he's still at 11 with the food, right?
Like, yeah. He can start smashing me.
10?
I think this game's over.
We have 10 attackers. He has 3-6 blockers.
I mean, that's a great card.
That was insane. Like, so... We can get Questing Dryad.
I think that's the card. I thought it was this card.
I guess, yeah, if we can.
And then we can return.
Sure, yeah.
It goes to the player hand, right? You can get the pump card.
It goes to hand.
Oh, it's only plus two. Oh. I can't get that. Oh, we can get this.
No, permanent.
Oh. We can get this card. It might be good.
Yeah. I think we can just get the black-white card back, and then the black-white card gets Questing Druid.
Yeah.
We want to use our... We want to go land Utopia Sprawl, though, I think, on, like, black or white paper. Make sure to, yeah.
Oh, wait, for Questing Druid?
Play the Acolyte, yeah. Oh, I think we have enough. I think we're enough. Yeah, we're good. We get Questing Druid, I think. Maybe that was wrong. Maybe we get the plus two plus one there. But I think this is good.
Yeah, we'll see. He's got two more, so he'll have six. So he'll have eight blockers.
Yeah. And he has to double block the. Yeah, like, not everything is two. Nine blockers. So let's.
That's good.
I think we bottom that.
I think you're right, right?
I mean, let's.
I don't want to draw though.
Draw the, like, green fight spell, or, like, the deal damage.
That's true. Yeah, you're right.
So we want to... Oh, we can... Yeah, yeah. We want to do that. Because we can also draw the minus two card.
Oh.
I mean...
I think we should just attack everything, right?
Yeah. Just face. I think he's, like, exactly. Or, like, he's a negative one.
Does he start milling cards, though? Oh, pay life.
Yeah.
Who are these guys walking? Oh, that guy first. Yeah. Cool. Felt like we shouldn't have won.
Dude, I feel like we shouldn't have won like three of these games.
I think once these board states get big enough, people just get really confused.
Oh yeah, for sure.
I had no faith. Wow.
I mean, that's one of the hard parts about Magic, is like figuring out when it's profitable for you to do something.
Mm-hmm. When you actually attack. Yeah, I'm like, man, just you bringing up that miss of killing the Ashiok for free, basically. It's like, ugh.
I think we.
Yeah.
Guess we can keep.
Yeah.
Do you toss back Daredevil here? Or Monstrous Rage, probably, right?
I thought it was the Glutton.
No, I don't think you toss back Glutton.
I think we want to be Questing Druid. Red Cap Thief. Yeah, you're probably right. Probably just Daredevil then. I just thought like this would go into this so well.
Yeah, I think we're just like giving up a lot of equity if we put back Glutton.
Just Questing Druid. Or do we want to use this to try to get mana?
I think on his end step, you use it to try and hit lands, actually.
Okay, I'm with you. Can I cast this now, right? Doesn't matter.
Sure. Yeah.
I mean, yeah, that probably seems about right, I guess.
Because, like, if we go land Red Cap Thief, we can go next turn.
Just cast those two.
Woodchopper Druid. And then the following we can cast the Glutton using Bargain on the treasure token.
Mm-hmm. he's gonna get a bunch of counters. Yeah, I think we cast these two, and then it's like if he attacks with the big guy, we could even. Yeah, these little guys, these 2-drop 2-3s kind of feel essential to get the green decks to the late game.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit. Attack, bro. Okay. Oh, nope. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I think we just glutton away our treasure and pass. And then, like, he's probably gonna save whatever to try and minus our creature on our turn so we can grow our guy with Monstrous Rage to play around the Dream Witches. Just like get in for 6.
Yeah, I feel confident about that attack.
Yeah. Especially with the ambush.
So, I mean, I can just trade with those too. I feel like he's gonna have a removal spell. But
I think that's fine.
No Gingerbread Throne coming after it, so that's gonna be give both.
Minus 3.
So I think he's gonna target the druid at this one. Oh wait. Yeah. So this is a good time to cast Monstrous Rage.
Yeah, so Monstrous Rage or what, I think?
So he's gonna get this -2/-2. So he gets 7 power. I have the Monstrous Rage the button, yeah. Attacks. Oh, damn it.
Let's just make 6 coins.
Get him for 5 guys. 6.
You just make 5, I guess, then he's king.
Yeah. I think I set him in with there. Like.
Maybe. I think we're just losing this game.
Yeah, I think we're gonna lose too.
And like flyers.
And guys in the wings.
Just play your Vanguard and it's a
perfect. I kind of want to bring the 5/5. Just do it, man. I'm gonna take it. It's gonna suck.
Yeah, I feel like he definitely attacks the 5/5 here. Just jump, I guess. I don't know.
I don't lie. I don't die, right?
Maybe you don't.
What did he choose? 3? Oh, I can get this other spell. Okay, let's see if I can kill him. Oh, cool. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, one off. Sean, thanks for helping me pilot to a pretty impressive record with this deck.
If I were able to like get something going with a little fire in the beginning.
Let's claim these surprises. Oh my god. Open this piece right away.
I'm gonna head to sleep.
Okay. Thanks, nice, Sean. Good talking to you.
Yeah, you too.
Not mana flare. These cards are cool. Alright, sweet. I think that was a stream. Later, guys.